See, I have God for my help. The Lord sustains my soul. I will sacrifice to you with willing heart and praise your name, O Lord, for it is good. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you to this Mass for the 16th Sunday of Ordinary Time. And for this weekend, we are celebrating the Mass from Our Lady of Guadalupe Church. To prepare our hearts to celebrate the sacred mysteries of our faith, let us ask God to forgive us our sins as we pray. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you, Lord, who care is for all people, to whom you should prove that you have not judged unjustly. For your strength is a source of righteousness, and your sovereignty over all causes you to spare all. For you show your strength when people doubt the completeness of your power, and you rebuke any insolence among those who know it. Although you are sovereign in strength, you judge with mildness, and with great forbearance you govern us, for you have power to act whenever you choose. Through such works you have taught your people that the righteous must be kind, and you have filled your children with good hope because you give repentance for sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, Lord, you are good and forgiving.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
You, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call on you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my cry of supplication.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
All the nations you have made shall come and bow down before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. For you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
But you, O Lord, are a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. Turn to me and be gracious to me. Give your strength to your servant.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus put before the crowds a parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field. But while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? He answered, An enemy has done this. The slaves said to him, Then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, No. For in gathering the weeds, you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest. And at harvest time, I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. Jesus put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nest in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until it all was leavened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A parishioner ordered flowers to be sent to the opening of his pastor's new office. And when the parishioner got there, he was shocked to see the flowers with the inscription, Rest in Peace. He was so outraged that he stopped at the florist to complain. And the florist said, It could have been worse. Just think. Today someone was buried beneath a floral arrangement with the inscription, Congratulations on your new location. My brothers and sisters, once again this Sunday, Jesus gives us 3 more parables. If you recall from my reflection and my homily last week, a parable is story. Story for each and every one of us to understand and better our own Christian life. So what are today's lessons? Well, with 3 stories, I believe there are 3 short lessons for all of us to ponder on this Sunday. A man sowed his field with good seeds. Then an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat. The two begin to grow side by side, and a friend says to the planter, Let us go pull those weeds. And the planter says, No, because if you pull the weeds, it will uproot the wheat. Lesson 1, evil will be present until the end of time, not because of God, but because of man's abuse of his freedom. But in the end, at the final judgment, and the final judgment is the harvest, God will ultimately triumph evil or God will ultimately triumph. Evil will be vanquished. The good will receive the reward in heaven, while the bad will receive their punishment. Our Lord makes use of this parable to show us the need to be vigilant against the contamination of our faith that can be caused by false prophets, and against worldliness, which dampens and weakens our Christian life and our mission to be God's instrument in the middle of this world. Be faithful to Christ and His church. Lesson one, God wants to confirm us in our faith. He wants us to persevere in choosing the good and having the firm hope that evil will never have the last say. The second parable, the mustard seed, the smallest of all seeds. Lesson two, for all of us to be reminded that mighty things through God's providence come in small beginnings, humble beginnings. And the best way for me to understand, to share with you this Sunday, is came to mind was two examples, you know, small, mighty things through God's providence comes in small beginnings. Look at the small beginning of Francis. Francis hearing the words, Francis, build my church. People followed Francis. People realized that from the little seed that he planted, people developed and found the monastic movement in time, and thousands upon thousands began to follow St. Francis of Assisi in his footsteps. But that little seed, Francis, rebuild my church, and imagine what it has grown to become. A second example when I hear this parable is, of course, the late Mother Teresa, today Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Here's this little, tiny, frail, humble, beautiful, devout Catholic nun who heard the words from God, go to the worst slums in the world. This little seed was planted, and I think you know the rest of the story. How Mother Teresa made a difference. How through mighty things and God's providence came from little Saint Teresa of Calcutta. Lesson two, my brothers and sisters, is don't worry about great things. You worry about being faithful. Don't worry about great things. Worry about being faithful. Let us be as faithful to St. Francis of Assisi and St. Mother, St. Teresa of Calcutta. And finally, the third parable, the kingdom of heaven. Basically, we ask the question, how do I get there? How do I get to the kingdom of heaven? Lesson three, God is telling us, put a little yeast in it. Yeast makes things rise. All it takes is one spark to set the world ablaze. Give your life to Christ and pray. In the name of Jesus, Satan and all evil be gone from within my being, my family, my world. And let God and His providence bring you to become the best version of yourself into a future full of hope, a future full of freedom, a future full of faith, a future full of joy. Thank you, God, today for these three lessons. God loves us all. He loves us so much that He sent His Son into our world to share these three parables with us so we can better our Christian life. Amen. Now together as a family we profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we now place before our loving God the intentions that we offer at this Mass.
For the Church, striving to live in openness to God's Word and revealed in our day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the wisdom that inspires governments to support the weakest members of society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For busy people seeking stillness in order to listen to God in their own hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this Christian community, call to put God's word of love into action every day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear these our prayers. Answer them according to your will. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my brothers and my sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Heavenly Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are holy indeed, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ronald Peter Fabro, our Bishop, Joseph, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you today.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of this world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock, says the Lord. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door to me, I will enter his house and dine with him, and he with me. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to the newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.